Good afternoon, everybody. All of the people who have come here before have started off with their company profile. They started off with the history of the company. Even I would do the same. Ravin Group is a 65-year-old company. This was started by Mr. Pramod Kale. We were pioneers in the electrical field.
Well, wow, that's nice. But how does that interest me and people sitting here?
Because we were star exporters of the cable of cables from India abroad. We have exported to more than 50 countries as well as 3 manufacturing units all over the world.
Well, that's impressive. But how does that concern me and again the audience?
Okay. I will tell you that Ravin Group has 5 verticals. It has many products, and there are different products that electrify your homes, your schools and your colleges.
Maybe, but again, that is not of interest to me and of course people here.
Okay, I'll tell you an interesting story.
Well, fine.
The name of the story is Knowledge is Power. During a recent bank robbery in Hong Kong, the bank robber shouted at everybody in the bank, "Don't move. The money is the government and your life's your own." Everybody in the bank lay down quietly.
Well, that's a mind-changing concept, changing the conventional way of thinking.
When the bank robbers returned home, the younger one, which was an MBA student, told the other robber, who was only a sixth standard primary school person, "Big brother, let's count how much money we got."
Then the older robber said that, "You're stupid. Why do we sit and waste our time in counting the money? This is huge money. Why not just see the news channel wherein they'll say that so-and-so money was robbed from so-and-so bank?" Well, that is what we call experience. Nowadays, experience is more important than just qualification papers.
After the robbery, the bank manager told the supervisor to call the police quickly. But the supervisor said to him, "Sir, why don't wait, let us take 10 million from the bank for ourselves and add it to the 70 million that we have previously embezzled from the bank."
Well, this is what we call swimming with the tide, converting an unfavorable situation to your own advantage.
It will be good if they rob the bank every day, said the bank manager.
Well, this is what we call killing boredom. Personal happiness is more important than your job.
The next day, the news report said 100 million was taken from the bank. The robbers counted and counted and counted, but they could count only 20 million. The robbers were very angry and complained, "We risked our lives, only took 20 million from the bank. The bank manager took 80 million. And that too, with a snap of his fingers. It's better to be educated than to be a thief."
That's why people say, knowledge is worth as much as gold.
The bank manager was smiling and happy because his losses in the share are now covered by the bank robber.
Well, this is what we call seizing the opportunity and daring to take risk.
This is what Ravin Group has done. We have always tried to seize opportunities. When we started trading, there was a scarcity of products. There was scarcity of cables in India. Now, as we grew, the scarcity reduced, and we had over supplies, and that's how we could export our cables abroad.
And today, Mumbai is enjoying 600 megawatts of power because of the project being executed by Ravin Group. And similarly, we have seized opportunity on the retail products also.
Yes, these retail products, we thought that the demand is there for these products, as your battery barely lasts even a day or maybe even a half a day. These products we all know that these batteries, and with the kind of mobile technology growing these days, we require some kind of products that would let develop in India on the board.
Well, to just give you some statistics, last year there were 300 million smartphones which were imported in India, and were sold in India, out of which 50% were bought by youth in India, which is ranging from age group of 15 to 24, which actually encouraged us.
We have seized the opportunity again and got these innovative products. These innovative products help people move on the go, as well as the batteries in these products are very innovative. We have solar chargers that help you power gives you power from the sun, as well as some very innovative ideas for the youngsters, like our music power bank, which helps you listen to music while you charge your phone.
Well, today's youth is very demanding. They want to stay stylish. They want to be in sync with latest trends. So, and not only looks, they also want utility. And I see almost 90% of the crowd here is youth, and I think they are in sync with what I'm saying. When you go and buy a product, you not only see if it is looking good or not, but you also see whether it is of use to me and it is going to prove for the whatever value I'm paying for it. So our products will completely match this thought of you and will be looking very good in your hand, and will also solve the purpose of charging your mobiles, your PSPs, your cameras, and all the products which are nowadays we call as power hungry devices.
We also have a few lanterns. We have a solar torch and a solar lantern. These lanterns and torches have been given solar power, as well as we put a feature that you can charge your phone with them.
Well, to just give you a situational background to this, just imagine you are in a classroom, your phone is, the class is going on after 6 o'clock or something, your additional classes, your mom is calling, your parents are calling, your phone is dying, you can't even message them that, you know, mom, I'll call you back. Your boyfriend are calling and you are somewhere, you know, where you can't contact them because your phone is switched off. Then they start imagining, their imagination will go on as to where is he or where is she. Similarly, there are many situations wherein you need charge for all these power-hungry devices and you don't have a backup for it. This is what we are into, this is what we thought of, and we got these power banks which, once charged and kept with you, will be supporting your devices so that they never die out of power.
Today, in the villages of India, people charge their phone with cycles using pedal power. Even this costs them money. This costs them 20 rupees per charge. While here, we pay about 10 rupees per charge, even through your normal AC source. These solar chargers help them, as well as lighting the villages with the solar lanterns.
Well, the concept here about the products is more about solar. Today, even we know that electricity has become a very expensive and a scarce resource. So, all this energy is from where we can get it at a very cheaper rate at almost zero cost is what we thought about and got these products in the market. That is solar. The product, if you see a solar charger, you can keep it on the dashboard of your car or in your backpack while you're just walking outside and get charged. And you can use it for charging your mobiles and these devices. So this is what we want to say is that, using solar and such energies is the need of the hour, and that is what we have got into it.
I would like to end with a quote of Steve Jobs: "Stay hungry, stay foolish." When you stay hungry, it's not the hunger, it's actually hunger for more knowledge. And foolish is that you have the guts to ask foolish questions and be foolish, so that you gain more knowledge.
Thank you so much. Thank you.